That is up and running.
We'll refresh this then. Never mind, it's doing its own thing.
It'll take. So we're online now. So and we're gonna be playing Momentum. It'll take you. The stream will be about 15 seconds behind, unfortunately.
Yeah, I muted the stream.
Yeah.
So I don't get the echo going, and it's really confusing.
Yeah, it gets really bad on the stream and for me. But yeah, so
that's
here's another indie game that we're gonna be playing from the indie game. Oh, get the tweet out. I always like to try to do that. Oh, it's just been a disaster. All right,
I love it when new things happen as soon as it's on other people's systems. If you restart the game, that might go away.
What's that?
Said if you restart the game, that should go away. The weird lighting effects that was happening.
Oh, it should be fine.
I don't know. I haven't seen that bug in a while.
Yeah, it's my computer and. Obviously, streaming has a tendency to do whatever it can to do that for some reason. I don't know why. I always find bugs on when I'm live. Let's see. Let's do that one. Let's do that one. Let's do that one. All right. So we'll do that. All right. So. Am I okay with mouse and keyboard? Should I use my controller?
I would say controller's better. Okay. Mouse and keyboard's an option, but it's subpar. Yeah. Wow, that is funky.
I don't know what game bar is. I don't know if I want to open that. Alright, so I don't know why it's trying to continue. I haven't played this.
It's because I was a little bit lazy.
Okay.
I mean... It's only ever going to show that once, ever.
Okay, so this is a momentum-based game. Obviously, you kind of see we have a marble, and we're going to be on a map here. Now if I can get figure out how to make it go.
I just push any key.
Oh, there's that one.
Yeah. And then, are you using the gamepad?
I am using the gamepad.
Okay, so yeah. The left thumbstick tilts the track, and the right thumbstick controls the camera. Today to go next level.
There it goes. Oh yeah, whoa! That's gonna take a little bit of time to get used to.
You can invert the controls if that's more what you're used to.
No, I was just trying to get it to spin around and trying to get it to move and not go too crazy. So the whole basis of the game here is we're trying to... Oh. Right there. Oh, so it gives you a little bit of time to kind of look in the beginning there. Okay.
Yeah.
And I would assume that if I roll too much, it's going to get extremely upset with me and go too quickly.
It's not too bad as long as there's rails there.
Okay. So, and this comes out... You're coming out on Thursday? This
Friday.
Releases? Or Friday it releases.
Yeah. After a long time of development.
Yeah, no, that's good. And how much y'all gonna charge this thing on... Because it's on Steam.
Yeah, it's on Steam and Xbox One. It'll be $10.
That's not bad.
Yeah, I like the share price.
Left trigger, what does left trigger do?
Well, let's turn the map and see. It's a break.
Oh, okay. Oh, see? Yeah, that's what I was afraid was going to happen. Bye, Carl. Yeah, I know, your life is
right over the top of it.
Uh I'm all gun shy and stuff. But no, it's a cool game. I remember playing. What was it? It's not nearly. It's a lot more intricate, and the tracks are better. But like, what was it? Marble Madness or whatever it is I played when I was younger.
There's a bunch of games.
Yeah.
Just upsettingly generic titles, unfortunately.
Yeah, it is. So, is there gonna be like a level editor or anything?
I mean, it'll be post-release.
Okay.
If we end up doing that, thing is, kind of need a critical mass of users to make that worth doing.
Okay. Yeah, it's definitely something that I could see. Like I'm horrible. I don't have an Xbox because, well, I refuse to.
It's fine.
Well, it's just it is what it is, right? I get there's certain things with Xbox that frustrate me, like the having to pay for online work, you know. So if I want to go play with my buddies, you know, and that's nothing to do with, you know, your game or anything like that. That's, you know, that's Xbox. And then PlayStation's starting to do the same thing now too. But I could see, like, if I had an Xbox, this would definitely be something that I would. Well, you can get a little squirrely there.
Yeah.
But this would be something that you could, you know, I could see sitting down. Oh yeah, let's, you know, we're all kind of hanging out and let's see how fast we can actually get going with this thing. And then, you know, passing the controller around and stuff like that. So,
right,
all that working right off the site. Oh, nice! You give me little arrows to tell me which way to go to.
Those are usually on the checkpoints.
Oh yeah, I just had to use one.
The general philosophy is, if you're on a checkpoint, then you shouldn't be lost. But if you're taking shortcuts and stuff, kind of on your own, you know?
Yeah. That brake's really helpful.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bud, I know. You have to give me. Carl's not happy today. Carl's the dog. Yeah, the bot I use actually shows me that you're in chat, and but the good thing with chat is then if because this one takes some concentration, so unfortunately whenever I, or unfortunately I should say whenever I when I play games that require that much concentration, it gets kind of, I don't want to go faster.
It turns the level faster. It doesn't like speed up the ball.
Oh, okay.
It's particularly useful for keeping the track under the ball.
Yeah, which is the problem I just had.
Yeah. But really, the main reason that's there is so that the tilt sensitivity is an option. Because what the boost does is it boosts the tilt sensitivity to like 125% of the maximum.
Oh, wow.
So you could actually have it at a low sensitivity and actually be able to do parts like this if you know, use boost.
And then, are you guys going to be... Is this going to be a VR game eventually?
I'm going to start looking into that option in the future. I mean, if I can get funding to do that, hell yeah.
Yeah, I'm not doing VR myself just because... I'm not sure how that would do with streaming. I've kind of seen a couple of people do it, but I think it would be disorientating to people.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, just sitting here watching me with a, you know, a mask on my face and people trying to figure out what the heck I'm doing.
I think a lot of games will start basically having a streaming option.
Yeah,
basically, you'd have a second display with a second in-game camera that's more stable.
Yeah, and the ones that I've seen that I was like, okay, well, that's cool, but then it's still you're looking at me with this mask on my face. So I don't know. I might eventually do it, but that's a lot of money to lay out.
But yeah, VR is exciting for sure.
I guess I didn't figure out where. There it goes. I'm doing all right. So how many levels are in this thing?
90.
90 levels.
Yeah.
So and I've gone through. I'm on 9. And we're going a couple of minutes already here. We're not doing too bad.
Yeah. It'll start getting harder.
I'm sure it's gonna do that on me. These things have a tendency to do that really quickly. For those guys that are coming in here, I am playing Momentum. I've got one of the developers in chat with me. Are you the developer?
Yes.
Okay. So is this another single person project or?
Well, I have a partner. He does the music and some of the sounds, right? But I'm everything else.
Oh, nice. Hey, Lurch. Hey, Prez. What's going on, guys? So we're playing Momentum. We got the developer in here. This is another game from Indie. The Game Guild here in Utah, or Utah Games Guild. These guys are awesome. I actually met you a couple of times. The last time was at Gaming Con.
Yeah.
Holy, what the hell?
It's not that bad. It's just long.
Well, yeah, the whole, like, it's inside, outside. So the cool thing with this, and really the thing that I like seeing in this, is being able to see somebody else's vision of a game, right? And that's the part of the reason I like. I don't understand what. Oh, that's not. I went the wrong way. That's what I said. But I love getting some of these. So X causes, what does X do again?
If you hold X while you're moving slowish, you can place it on a checkpoint. Underneath your face cam, there's an icon that shows how many checkpoints you have available.
Oh, okay, down at the bottom right.
Yeah.
So I can do one.
Yeah.
I don't know, for some reason I can't seem to oh, that's what's happening.
Yeah, you have to be moving slow enough. Just so you can't be like, oh, I'm gonna die, place a checkpoint.
Well, no, what was happening was I was going and the track changes direction.
Oh.
So I'm used to the controls going one way and then they shifted.
Gotcha.
So, like, I would go to move the track, and the ball would just jump off the edge and laugh at me hysterically and plummet it to its death.
Gotcha.
But yeah, like I was saying, I really do enjoy playing indie games, mostly because there's some. Let's go this way. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, I wouldn't. The games I normally play, I wouldn't play this game. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't have picked it up. I would have been like, oh, okay. Maybe if it was on sale or something. But I have so much fun playing with them. It's just actually a blast. Like I played Josh's game, and it was just cool. And I don't normally play that type of game, but I had so much fun playing it. And that was Legacy of the Elder Star, which is actually out. We actually played that game a while ago, and it's a really really fun game. What's the other ones? We play a couple of other side scores. I cannot get this thing to go the direction I want it to go.
Oh. You need to flatten out there, I guess.
Yeah, it doesn't want to, like, it's like the camera's as far down as it will go and it won't let me.
Oh, I see what you're saying. So, by default, there's a option called Horizon Lock that's set to on.
Okay.
Basically, what we found in the early play tests, is people would end up looking straight up or straight down, and that doesn't really give you much perspective information, right?
Yeah.
So by default, it's locked, so the camera can only move so far, so up or down, such that the horizon's always on the screen.
Okay.
But you can't turn that off. Oh. It's nice to turn it off for the later levels.
Yeah, like this one, like there's a couple times I was really afraid, and I'm sure you're probably seeing it on the stream now, that I'm actually just jumping off the edge. But it was actually rolling over almost completely on its side, and like...
Yeah.
I can see, and so are you guys going to have leaderboards and...
I wasn't really planning to, because that requires... I guess Steam does have their basic leaderboards, but for a more general approach, it requires our own servers and stuff.
Yeah.
And also, I would have to learn a lot of cryptography.
There's that. I wasn't sure, because they're all timed, so I wasn't sure if you're going to have... You know, the top times for each level or something.
I mean, that would be nice, but I'm too much of a noob to do that without, like, it just being a spam fest of hackers.
Yeah, there's that too. Start removing guardrails on me. That's not cool, yo. Oh, my controller got me that time. What? The problem is I know you just went out. That's the problem, buddy. He's upset because Brooke is out of town tonight. So he's being difficult. That's the whiny dog you hear in the background. He gets a little whiny when she's gone. Oh, almost saved it.
Did almost save it.
Oh. So close. Oh, seriously, Carl. But yeah, so I guess, you know, some of the things we ask is like, so where'd the your inspiration come from for this? And
so there's the old labyrinth mazes, right? The old wooden labyrinths.
Yeah.
Those, eventually somebody got the idea to turn those into a 3D thing. That was called Perplexus. You usually find those at like Walmart or something.
Yeah.
Fitness toy. And
yeah.
That was basically the idea for this. I wanted to do a game out of that.
Okay. I know, bud. Well, you can come set up on my lap then. Come here. Okay, well, if you're just gonna be difficult. Alright, no, this isn't cool, yo. Like corkscrews and stuff. That takes some concentration to get that thing to go right. Holy cow!
Oh. I'm gonna guess you barely made it. Yeah, you barely made it.
Don't let him lie to you. He's been fed today. We've taken him out several times. he's just upset. So, he did give me a second key for this game. So at the later in the stream here, we're gonna give that key away. So if you guys are interested in trying to play this game on your own, let me know and we'll throw it up in the chat here, and we'll use the bot to give it away. Oh, there's no guardrail there.
Careful.
Well, the way I was looking at it, I couldn't even see that there wasn't a guardrail.
Unfortunately, care management is definitely part of the game, you know? Like, I tried to make it such that it doesn't do anything on its own. Because it's inherently tied to the control scheme.
Oh, almost had it. Aha. he said, no thanks, I'm already going bald. I don't need to rip more hair out. That is awesome. Don't get me wrong, I'm not the best person at these type of games, but holy crap. It makes you think you can do it, that's for sure.
Well, what I'm seeing, you're almost at the end there.
Yeah, we got that one that time.
Nice.
That definitely came to lurch. This is definitely,
had to do a subtle change on that level. Those, horizontal corners used to be curves. So what people would do is they'd like accidentally launch off of those corners and go flying off. Like scale it back a bit.
This thing's not even nice. Definitely a good use of the track using both sides of it, so
I like to be efficient like that.
Then there's the ones where you're just like, I don't know how I made it through that one. Just pure silly, silly luck. Oh, that's not good. Oh, there it went. Spatial awareness is definitely a thing. Best part, yeah, this is ridiculous. Oh, my favorite part again, the no guardrails. A little bit better that time. Oh. Yeah, I'm murdering that brake. That button's getting its workout today.
I almost considered making it a toggle.
it may be. Just go in and be like, do you want to press to remove the brake or press to add the brake? Lord. Alright, now the bad part is I have no idea which direction I go, because I think I just jumped part of the track.
Find a checkpoint, you'll be fine. Unfortunately, I can't, like, give you direction on account of that 15-second delay.
Yeah.
It's like, go left. But you've already turned the camera around.
Well, there's a checkpoint. Oh, it seems like I'm going the right way. Until I go do that again and go the wrong direction.
Spare checkpoint on this level. Oh. Doesn't tell you where to go, but I would suggest using it at the little wire bit. It's the halfway point.
Yeah, the little wire bit seems like a good place. Oh, that's the A button evidently makes it jump.
Yeah, it's for taking shortcuts.
I had the brake on and I pressed X, but it doesn't seem to
hold X.
Nope. It's not liking me.
I can't quite tell what's going on. So, there's a few requirements for the checkpoint. You need to be moving slow or standing still, and it needs to be ground under you.
Okay, I got it to work finally.
Okay. Like, around the icon, you'll see this little, like, progress bar thing. When that fills up, you can place it, but...
Oh. So like I said, the bot was nice enough to remind us this game does come out August 12th, so it comes out this Friday. It will be on Steam. So, and you said it was $10?
Yep.
Nice. That's actually, like I said, that's a lot of levels. I do like games that are, I like games that you get your money back out of. And I think, you know, 90 levels and, you know, for $10, if you enjoy this sort of game, you're definitely going to get your money out of it. But I would definitely recommend a controller. So I don't know if I could do this with a keyboard and a mouse. I'm sure it's possible. I'm sure there are people out there that can do it. All about positioning of the camera. Holy cow. I hope I'm still going the right way.
Yeah, you're fine. Well, that was 15 seconds ago.
It looks like it is. There's another checkpoint up here I haven't activated yet. I guess that first jump didn't get me very much. Got all excited, thought I had found a good shortcut. Nope. Oh, there it went. I was getting close. You don't have video press?
What do you mean?
Try refreshing the game to see... Or refresh it, not the game, but refresh, refresh Twitch. Twitch is twitchy.
Yeah, but I'm getting video. It's fine.
I'm getting going too fast. Thank you. then the next thing you need to do is I'm big fans of Rooster Teeth. I love that company basically.
They've gotten big.
Yeah, they have. They're amazing. But this would definitely be a good one for Michael and his rage quit.
I gave the generic Rooster Teeth contact email a couple keys.
Yeah.
Including Xbox keys, actually, since I know they do a lot of Xbox stuff. I didn't hear back from them, so... Eh? I mean, not much more I can do than that.
Yeah, no, that's really all you can do. I know that the Rage Quit guys... I can see him breaking a controller on this one. Because I'm sure there's going to be some point where there's just hundreds of deaths in a row.
Yeah.
What the hell? Got a twisted mind comes up with this stuff.
Isaac actually made this level. Not me.
Almost had it. And I got no save points on this one either.
It's a fairly short level, so... I mean, you don't go on the outside, so...
Just gonna hold down the brake toggle again. Nope. So is there going to be, do you have achievements for it, stuff like that too,
yeah.
Or no? Okay.
So all the achievements are tied into the in-game achievements as well, and those give you different ball skins.
Oh, nice.
So there's actually a reason to do them.
Oh yeah, bragging rights.
And of course on Xbox, they, you know, also give you game score, I guess.
Yeah. So are they just tied to beating levels, or is it tied to...
It's a variety of things, right? Like, some of them are get X amount of bronze medals, X amount of silver medals, X amount of gold medals, or, like, total, grand total X below gold par. And there's three of them. You had to build beat specific levels without breaks.
Oh, jeez.
Those ones are hard.
Off the edge. Getting through each level looks like enough. You would think.
We did make it so that, you know, all you have to do is beat levels to get through it.
Oh, nice.
In fact, you only have to beat every other level to get through it. In fact, beating a level unlocks the next two after it.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good. So if you do get really, really stuck on something, you can just be like, yep, I'm done.
Yeah.
These are great, because it's just this vertical drop with a barely little bitty guardrail down there. Oh, you'll see in a minute.
Yeah, you'll not like the next, or the last level in this world. Because it's this level... without guardrails.
Oh, this level without guardrails.
Yeah, with a little bit of change as well.
That sounds like fun. Shortcut. It doesn't sound like fun.
Yeah. At that point, if you haven't learned the trick to getting through level, you're like, how do I stop in time?
Yeah, having to burn the... get it to bring back quickly.
Yeah. Basically, what you have to do is you have to get a little bit of speed going, so that by the time you hit the corner, you're already a bit, you know, uphill. It's not level at that point, right?
Oh, okay.
If that makes any sense.
Oh, I was trying to skip it. It's not working the way I wanted it to. Get too much speed on this thing and it just ends badly for you.
Yeah, definitely the right amount.
That is so difficult. At least for me, anyway.
Yeah. Well, it is supposed to be a sort of difficult game. So I guess mission accomplished?
Yeah, it's trying to... just enough just to get to... Aha! Now I just gotta get around the edge. I do like how the marble makes it clunk. It's kind of satisfying. Oh, this side's much easier.
Yeah.
Well, at least you feel like you accomplished something when you get through it.
Yeah, that's the thing I like about challenging games, you know? You have that sense of satisfaction if you actually get through it. As opposed to, like, really easy games, like, why am I even doing this?
Yeah, it's, you know, it is what it is. But yeah, if you're definitely interested in a challenge and something to kind of... make you actually think in more dimensions than just one. I was actually playing a little bit of Space Engineers this morning, and sometimes that one gets my head kind of messed up with the way it's you know, aligning things. This one, it's got nothing on this one.
I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Well, if you like that 3D space like type game, it's definitely a good thing. If you want to have something that's kind of different and, you know, a different approach to things, as opposed to just, you know, every other crazy thing that's out there. And I like different. So this one, I don't know. I'm feeling. I was like, I gotta do it now. I gotta get further. I can't even see my ball. There it is. Oh, this looks safe.
It's totally safe.
Not safe at all. I've just bombarded Central Park with another marble. It's not a safe place to be.
technically it's like a 2 meter wide ball of steel too.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would leave a small impact. Oh, what the hell? Does it?
I like how that's your reaction to every level.
Gallard, you're an evil, evil man.
Sorry.
Well, it's not really like the level I'm not worried about. It's the sharp corners.
Yeah, that is actually the point of this one.
The sharp corners are not cool. Because if you have any speed and you're going over these ones like this, it just launches it. And then the inside ones just rob you of all the momentum that you're carrying.
It's not the worst thing, though. I mean, that means you can go really fast on the inside parts.
Yeah.
Without going off an edge. Which is rare.
Then the outside ones, not so much. I will say that the background is definitely cool. The few moments that I get to look at it. Ah. But no, yeah, the background, the sunset, the artwork is really nice.
It's good. It's good. I appreciate that.
So one thing I do enjoy. Oh, okay. I don't know what this is. I'm not sure about the electric fence on the outside.
But oh, that's just to stop you from jumping over.
Ooh. Okay. So just okay. So you could theoretically just use the jump button, spin the map over.
Yeah, from the right spot anyway. So what it does is, while you're not in contact with the track, your level of control decays rapidly. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just to prevent you from doing really stupid stuff. Like, this entire level, screw that. I'm just gonna jump, spin it under me, and land.
Yeah.
Done.
Like, I'm out. What's going on, bud? Yeah. Hey, look. Either come up here. No, come here. Hey, no, come here. Come here. Here. Now you can come sit my lap now. There. Is that better? There, sit down. There. Now you can be. You can lick my hands now. Alright, sit down. Oh. There it goes. I think my controller's being wonky again.
Sorry to hear that.
No, it's. I have a Logitech G710. It's a wireless controller, but every once in a while, like, it just goes through this phase where it's just like, nope, I don't want to give you those inputs today.
Could hear this working at all though, because yeah, I obviously can't test with like a bunch of types of controllers.
Yeah, well, no, it's a problem with a controller. It's something, I don't know if it's just the controller I have or what. Or it'll just like it'll stick and it'll just keep moving even though I let go of the controls. So one of these days I'm gonna break down and just go buy a wired controller.
I mean, you can get Xbox One wireless controller to work with Windows.
Yeah, and then, or just do that. The Xbox, I don't know if I buy the Xbox One one. I'd probably get like a 360 one because they're a lot cheaper.
Yeah, they are.
Or Logitech has, I think it's a 310, which is pretty much the exact same controller except for it's wired.
I really wish Logitech actually named their devices.
Yeah. Actually, I do a lot of the controls I have now are Mad Cats. So I really like their stuff. I have the MMO7 mouse. I have a Strike 7 keyboard. I have a Cytec joystick. But I have a Logitech gamepad. That corner is just kicking my butt.
Yeah, you gotta go real slow on it. Try zooming in. The right bumper, whatever is equivalent to the right bumper, I guess.
Let me. Can I get through it? I will try that when we get over here. We get kind of stuck for a second. Oh no, I was zoomed all the way in. Oh no, I wasn't. Oh, you can zoom all the way in. So that's cool. That's one thing I do like about this controller too, is it's a more metal balls. Yes, Carl, more metal balls. I know, but what? Well, you already have food. You already went out. She's not coming home tonight because she's in Atlanta. So I don't know what you want me to tell you, buddy. Oh yay, and there's no guardrail, so that's good. That's my favorite part.
Yeah. But only for that little bit.
Oh, you lied. There's another little bit.
It's the same little bit, technically.
Oh, didn't go back up. I originally thought it was the battery lurch, but it's not. Like, I can go replace the battery, and it will still do it. It has a moment where it's going to be difficult. Really? Now you're licking my hand? You know how hard it is to play video games when you're licking my hand?
My mom's dog has obsessions with licking everything.
Well, it's weird. Like, it's my girlfriend's dog. And for some reason, it loves licking my feet and my hands. But it's only me and my daughter that it will do it to. I just...
That's bizarre. I think it does it because it was raised with a cat in the house.
He's a really good dog. He's actually...
That's good.
See if we can keep it kind of lined up here. Ha-ha! Is that better now? You feel better? Alright, he laid down. He's just, and whatever, well, she, Brooke had him for a couple of years before I met her, and he was a rescue dog. So, he, whenever she's gone, he doesn't know how to handle it, so. But he's a good pup. That, and he's older too, so. It makes it a little bit harder on him. Fun. I get to this level, I'm like, oh, this one doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, I tried to make breaks, if
you will. until that part. Just a couple of parts where you need to go a little slower. Get the camera going the right direction. The music's pretty cool too.
Thank
Send Isaac your compliments.
It's kind of soothing, kind of put down the axe, you know.
Yeah, that was really the idea, the whole aesthetic, right?
Yeah. It's okay, you'll make it through, just take a deep breath. You have moments like that that you just catch it just by the skin of its teeth. Holy cow.
Yeah, those actually happen quite frequently. At least for me.
Yeah. Just like, I'm afraid to touch it. Oh. I didn't look out there. Oh, there it went again. Yeah, the brake doesn't seem to work so good when it loses contact with the ground.
As brakes tend to do, yes.
The whole friction thing goes out the window when you're in the air. Looked down to see, I was like, nope, don't have a save point. Nope, I don't even know where I was going with that one. It's going so well.
Is that last turn?
I know, it's definitely as fun and as challenging. So I'm guessing that I'm like on, it was like one on of 20 something. So how many levels are in each section?
There's 34 or so in the first one, and about 30 in the second one.
The remainder in the last one?
Yeah. Like, it's not an even amount on each. Can't remember the exact numbers off the top of my head.
That's fine, it's not like it matters. How many are there? It's one of those things. I honestly, like, the only way I even know that I'm on different levels is that every once in a while I catch the number when the scenes change.
You can just pause it.
That takes all the fun out of it. Oh! You get through it, Carl. You too. So it says 115.8 plus 12.
The plus 12 is the death penalty.
Oh.
So every time you die, it goes up by 2 seconds. Originally, we had it such that there was no death penalty, but your time didn't reset when you would go to a checkpoint.
Okay. I think the death penalty is probably better.
It is, yeah. Much.
I don't think I like this part.
You can do it.
Yep, that I saw that one coming. Oh, yeah, see, I just get too much into it. I'm gonna try. Oh.
Oh, that's when you're so close. Delayed reactions. Great.
Yeah. Oh, there's no guard roll there either, so that's good. Just believe you can find touch the sky. Let me let go of that for a minute. I want to zoom back out. It's okay, Carl. I gotta go back through all of that.
Oh, you didn't quite get to the checkpoint?
Nope, not quite.
That sucks.
No, you're fine, man. That went a little bit better that time. Trying to figure out that movement to get the movement down so that it goes where you need it to go.
Right.
Trying to save my checkpoint because I think I know where I'm going to need to use it.
I guess right in front of the movement.
Yeah. Right there. Of course, then I don't need it. What's going on, bud? What? Let him go. Ow. Yeah, the graphics are amazing. The like even the steel ball, like the reflections on it, like everything. If you actually zoom all the way in, you can see the reflections of the background on the ball itself.
Notably not the dynamic stuff, but you know. Could have done that, but it there's just way too much of a performance hit for way too little game.
Yeah. Well, and then for the most part, you know, you start getting into that, you start having to use extra resources and things like that.
Yeah.
Like, don't get me wrong, most computers that people are playing on nowadays shouldn't really have a problem with it, but... But why bother?
I tried not to push it, you know? I mean... Overall, there's not too much optimization graphics-wise. Because, you know, I can't really do, like, level of detail stuff.
Yeah.
Since it's all supposed to be accurate physics and stuff.
Well, that's definitely good physics.
It's good to see that you haven't run into the occasional times where it'd be all janky ball.
What's that?
There's some bugs with the physics, right? Like, can't really do anything about.
Yeah.
Like, if you have a flat surface that's composed of two objects, but they're flush. Sometimes the ball will hit just while running across that seam.
Oh, wow. It'll bounce.
Yeah. I mean, there's nothing I can do about that, too. It sucks.
You know what? I'm just going to put that there just in case I need to. I didn't realize I was that close to the end, but whatever.
Just in case.
He just took her. If you read this, you're too close.
An old classmate of mine actually wanted me to do it first person.
Oh, jeez. But some of them, it may actually be easier. Like, if you were here, like all the way zoomed in, would probably be a little bit much. Because you'd need to be able to see what's coming up with the track. But, like, this close sometimes may even work better, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's why it's there. It's for the precise ones, right?
Oh, awesome. There's no guardrails. That makes me happy.
Wow.
Buddy. No, but yeah, like I was saying, I really do enjoy getting games from the Utah Games Guild. There's some really cool ideas you guys are running with, so.
Yeah, we'll take all the help we can get. I mean, I think almost all of us suck at social media.
Yeah, I'm trying to get better at it. I have my moments too, though. Yeah, but you know, if you're trying to run a stream or something like that nowadays, you almost have to. At a very small hill. But it seems like he was saying that the
yeah,
it doesn't always happen, right?
It doesn't always happen, and the flat surface is the generic case, right? But that's any flush surface, including curves. So I would have to make a specific small hill for every different combination of pieces.
Yeah, so then it would be like riding damn moguls and skiing. That'd probably be worse. That'd probably be less fun.
It is somewhat alleviated by the fact that I do some merging with the level loads. So that instead of the original pieces, it's like, here's a chunk of pieces.
Yeah. No, it's definitely a cool idea. It's definitely something new and different.
Thanks.
I just saw the mountains in the background of here. Those look familiar.
Suspicious.
Yeah, it's kind of a bit of familiarity there. It's weird.
Don't remember that, you know, ocean being there, but
yeah, I don't know about yeah, some fiction. It's fine. Oh no, but it's cool. I have a lot of fun with, like I said. So what we're alluding to is the mountains in the background here look a lot like the Wasatch Front where we live at. So. Any chance that you are start that new chip. I'm not hearing a hum. You may hear my fans. I have a couple of fans. Obviously with this monster back here, it has 14 fans in it, I think.
Damn.
I always look, so there's 6, 8, 10, 12. So there's 12 fans that are running right now. And then I have a floor fan and then another fan up in my AC vent, trying to keep the room kind of cool. They're all turned down kind of low, but there's usually a bit of a hum in my stream. So, unfortunately, my mic kind of picks up everything.
Yeah, I don't know what you can do about that, other than, turn us up some directionality to the microphone.
Well, I have the directionality on it, stuff like that. So there is a little bit. I usually hear a little bit of a hum in the background, but I've tuned it out as much as I can to turn it down. So it's not as bad. And then still not have the mic sitting directly in front of my face like a lot of people do. So my mic is actually up above my monitor right now, so. Well, I do hear a hum in the background, so I tune it out because it's always there for me. Dude, there's not even bumps on the side of that.
We have arrived at the part where it gets.
It's not even nice, man. It does give me two freaking extra checkpoints, though. So that was nice of you. That's not gonna help me, but it's nice of you. I guess I could try to get cheaty more often. I'm not confident enough in my abilities to try that yet. Oh.
Yeah, that kind of stuff does make going back to earlier levels kind of fun. Trying to get all the gold medals and such.
Oh, trying to get the just the speed for it and everything?
Yeah. So, I mean, the first time through, you're probably not going to get gold. That's not expected.
Carl, bud. Hey. Relax. You're not dying, I promise.
Those are strange sounds for a dog.
He's older. When Brooke got him, they told him that he was 3, we're not entirely sure that was accurate. So we're thinking he's a lot older than they were telling us. This isn't even nice. Seriously, that's not nice. He's gonna try to jump it down there and catch it with the in the bottom of the loop, but yeah, good luck with that.
Yeah, you have to line it up before you do that.
Do they still talk to you? Oh. Turn that down a little bit. Ah. Just a little bit off angle, just a little bit, and it's just.
Yeah, you have to be pretty precise. Usually what I like to do is get close to the edge and then align the camera. So you're going like either forward or backward.
That helped a little bit. Almost went past the damn the checkpoint and didn't get it.
That would have been bad.
I sacrificed the ball to go back and get the checkpoint. Does give you an amazing sense of relief when you get past parts like that, though. Until the next one. Boink. All right. Let me see. I've got one. I burned one somewhere.
Can't see them, so.
Yeah, I still have one. Oh. Seriously. Alright, fine. We're gonna go over here. Did it. So, the first time I was like, oh, this is... Yay! Yep, fell. too much speed.
The sharpest bit of the curve is the first bit. So if you just get through that bit, then you should be set for the rest of it. So close.
Just kicking my butt right now. Oh, dang it, wrong way. Past that stuff now. Probably gonna regret that in the future, but.
Nah, it should be fine. I mean, that's the past the hardest bits, so. Just the one twist and then you're done.
The end. There's a light at the end of the tunnel, and it might not be a train. This level. I rode a roller coaster that looked like this one time.
I'm sorry. That must have been horrible.
It was fine until it got to the other end and came back. Oh.
I was like trying to find the sweet spot on this one. It's a constant curve, right? So theoretically, there's a camera position and a thumbstick position that if you just hold that, it'll guide you all the way through it.
I'm not falling for your tricks. It's outside. Good news is it spins somewhere at the end of it, too.
Hooray!
What a mess! Great.
By the way.
Oh. at such a tight radius.
Yeah.
Oh, is it being twitchy again?
Yeah, it might be my end though.
Yeah, I run fairly high settings, but I actually lowered them a bit. We're running at 720 at 30 frames right now.
There we go. Got it back.
I'm pretty sure I'm running about 120 frames on my end. Nice, you put a little guardrail in there for us. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna like this part. That's gonna take a minute to get the mind around. No, it's okay, you can go over, don't be afraid. I'm kidding, be afraid, Ball, be afraid! It's messed up, it doesn't tell you which way to go when you do that, too.
A little bit, yeah.
Oh, maybe on the other side. Maybe over here.
Like
you
beat it.
Yeah. Probably had to end of that one. Oh, awesome.
I detect a hint of sarcasm.
No.
Oh yeah, this one is a bit of a bitch. Enough such that I would not blame you at all if you wanted to skip it.
We'll give it a couple of... No, I want you to turn the camera so I can see where I'm going. I'm talking to my hand, it's not listening.
Shh.
hang out there for a minute. Just chill. It'll be alright. Oh. You're so close. And there's a little rampy, bumpy thing in the middle. My favorite.
That's the part that's the bitch.
Oh. I like that you narrowed it down to that one little bitty piece. That's the bad, hard part. Oh, I didn't even see it that time. Holy crap. The rest of it's fine. Just the little bumpy in the middle. That's the hard part.
Yeah, the rest of it's fine. You can go real slow and everything, but that just kind of like throws you off violently.
It's so hard, and it's so hard to see it too.
Yeah, I'm wondering if I should do something with that checkpoint, such that when you die and come back, the light's not at that angle. Because that's like literally the worst angle it could be at.
Yeah, it's. Or even like. Like right there, I can see it. Obviously, you'll see it in a minute. But like once you get a little bit closer, once you get that little bit of down tilt, it just disappears.
Yeah. Okay, I should probably do something about that.
Oh, well, I needed to buy it. All right,
we did.
We're gonna burn that.
That's a good idea.
I have a feeling I'm gonna need it. Does the brakes not work on the?
Not particularly well, no. It's proportional to the.
How much friction you have?
Well, it's proportional to the. The verticality of the track you're on.
Okay.
Which, when they're rails like that, it kind of throws it off quite a bit. Well, that was just.
Wow.
Violent. Brake does do some. It's not as much as it otherwise would.
Ah, I just cannot get that thing to spin fast enough.
Using both triggers?
Yeah. It's trying to slowly get it to where it moves. Alright, I'm just gonna do a little bit of crazy here. Oops, wrong direction. Nope. Yeah, I just cannot get it to spin fast enough. To slow it down once it starts moving.
Yeah, that's hard. It's possible, it's just hard.
I thought the little bump was the hard part.
It's most of the hard part.
Nope. Ow. Yeah, I don't know if I'm doing something wrong. I'm sure it's beatable, but
try making it such that it's not perfectly level. Does that make any sense? You're leaning a bit more on one side than the other. I mean, obviously not too much, otherwise it'll go off, but there's a little bit of wiggle over there. That'll make it so the corner's effectively less sharp, and that should give you a little bit more friction.
Nope. Just... I feel sorry for that building right down there, though. Yeah, it just, even though I'm holding the right trigger, it's just not spinning fast enough to keep up with it. Like, I think I know what I need to do to make it work, but... Either that or I'm spinning it just half a second too late.
Yeah, it definitely shouldn't be this hard, though. I think I'll need to fix that in a patch. I just make that whole thing easier.
Yeah, I think this radius is just a little too tight.
You had that one.
I did. Back to that again. How do I go to skip it?
Go to the main menu, just take a bit, and then go to level select and just select the one after that.
Level select. Oh, so you can actually just go straight to the two also, that's cool.
Yeah, they each have their own difficulty curves, but they're steeper.
Oh, nice. Oh. Not used to having a controller in my hand for this long. Nice. Ah. Gonna try to see if I can just line it up and hit it, but didn't quite make it. Nope.
Sometimes you can do that. Yeah. Helps the track doesn't just boogie to the side, though.
At least I got the checkpoint. I think. I hope. Alright, good.
Makes everything worth it.
Easier on the side, you can like dive bomb it a bit. Well, at least the first half, anyway.
There for a minute, just relax. Kind of take it easy. Spin the camera around. All right. See what kind of disaster's up here waiting for us. Oh. Trying to spin that camera around, trying to get it to
in the right spot.
Right spot, and oh yay! Off it goes. Ah.
I don't like setting the camera sensitivity really stupid high, so I can flick it 90 degrees.
Ah. Yeah, just sometimes it gets that weird angle. Alright, we're gonna go. We're gonna go try level 2. Well, no, I wanna keep it moving. I wanna keep stuff kinda going. I don't wanna be.
Yes, that's fine. It's fine.
Get frustrated and get all freaking on one level and. Oh, yeah, that looks good. Whose idea was it to go to this one again?
It's just a big old laser wall.
I don't know if it's the laser wall that I'm worried about. What the hell am I supposed to do? Does the laser wall just kill me?
Yeah, the laser wall kills you. There's a button off to the side.
Oh, so you have to go through there a certain amount of time or you're hosed.
Yep.
Oh, that's good. Thank you. So I have to hit it again? Oh, and then my joystick decided to be its fun self. Get out of the laser wall. First, I thought I was gonna have to jump, so that was better than I was hoping for.
Yeah, that would be heinous.
Cruel and unusual punishment. That's what that would be. Oh yeah, it's a murder wall. That's good. A cool mechanic, though, at least.
That's good.
Well, it's, you know, oh, hell, this should be... No.
Do you like buttons?
Are these all timed, too?
No. Not at all.
You say that, I don't know if I believe you.
If the button has a green ring, it's permanent. If it has a red ring, it's timed. If it has a yellow ring, it's toggled.
Okay. Not now, controller. Oh, yeah, definitely. They're Donald Trump walls. I'm kidding. They're not Donald Trump walls. Can't hit it. Why didn't it go away? Oh, no, it did go away. The best part is getting to run all the way back down to the other end. Every single time.
Exercise and see, you know, how well you can break. How accurately you can break, rather.
Oh yeah, it's the best part is at the end there is no wall.
Was that really any different from a laser fence?
Not really. It's just a different animation. Oh!
Oh, come on. You got cheated out of that one.
Defenses of death. Ugh. Go where I want you to, camera. a fine line between getting enough momentum to get it to move and not too much to go roll over like a bulldozer.
For sure, yeah.
But like I was saying earlier, it is definitely a really cool idea. It is something that's definitely interesting. And as always with indie games, something a little bit different. That's, you know, I always say this, you know, with indie games, but it's because, you know, you can build the game you want. You can build your vision.
Right.
And other than, you know, trying to get the product out the door so that you can actually survive, you don't have somebody breathing down your neck. Well, we have shareholders. You have to... So...
I was really surprised how little input the Xbox team had, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they didn't press me for deadlines or anything at all.
Oh, nice. I know most places now, as long as you follow your own deadlines, they want you to, you know, they don't want to have something that's like on Steam Greenlight or something that was sold that's, you know, never goes into, you know, is never released. And this is a pretty polished and good put together. Like, I haven't really noticed other than just mechanics that I'm just, you know, my brain has difficulty with. Seems to be pretty cool. Now I'm all gun-shy because of last time.
I should have been really mean and made that last time one.
You'd have got people would have murdered you. Because they would have got all the way down to the bottom and just been like, are you kidding me? What the hell? Now I'm playing on a flute? Gonna be bad. Oh, where's the end at anyway?
So you see that bit at the end? When you get to that, it will do a little countdown, and then start turning. Basically, you have to ride it around.
Which bit at the end?
There's the little separate segment at the end.
Oh, that's crap!
It has rails.
Thank you. Nope, get out of there. Aw. There's some coming down and squishing me that's killing me. Ugh.
Yeah, they like to be in the way quite a bit.
Sneak through the hole.
Trying to go through it?
Yeah, see if I can just write on the backside of it. I think as soon as I hit the hole though, it's gonna trigger the animation for the dying.
I mean, theoretically you might be able to do that, but the problem is then you'd be doing the same gauntlet, but without rails.
Trying to cheat. Why not?
I mean, the shortcuts are fine. In fact, in some places, they're required to get the gold.
Either launch you in the air or freaking squish you.
Yeah, you gotta run around some of them quickly.
Oh, get out of there. Ah, dang it. The timing at the end is so... so iffy. Such a short time, too.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot of room.
Definitely interesting and challenging, so.
That is good. That is two things I hoped it would be.
Yeah, with the flute!
Ah.
God dang it. It's just so hard to get the camera lined up so that you can get...
Right.
To be able to see what you're trying to do and get past those things, and it's such a quick timing. And then if you do get past it fast enough, you just get squished. Alright. We'll try to see what the next one is. Oh, that looks like fun. Globe, it's a peach ball, a boulder. Oh, that one's kind of cool looking.
Which one?
The spiral ball to get 8 bronze medals. The vintage deco. That one kind of looks like an old diver's mask.
Favorite one is probably the
tire. What's
that? My favorite one is probably the tire.
Random ball unlocked by default.
Yeah, the random ball just picks a random ball every time you die.
Oh, okay.
From the ones you've unlocked. Here.
Complete 320 without using brakes. Well, at least tells you which ones you need. The tire. Pretty funny. The hamster ball with a hamster in it.
In case you wanted to be, I don't know, sadistic.
So does the random one pull ones that you don't have too?
No, it's just from the ones that you unlocked.
That you opened. We'll go with random. We'll go look at 3. See what that background looks like. Does it give you more traction? Background here, though.
Thanks. I like this one.
Come on. There you go. Oh, I do not believe I will be collecting all of them.
Easy. All right.
I'm not sure what the blue boxes are, but I don't believe I'm going to like them.
It'll tell you when I approach them. But no, you won't.
Prevent jumping. Nice. Oh, I'm sure one of these would be prevents, like...
Breaking?
Breaking, and...
Yeah, you're right.
I think it's gonna be this one. Yeah, I saw that one coming. Oh, wow. Yeah, speed booster. That's pretty much what it is. Like, oh, by the way, we got rid of all the railings, so we thought we wouldn't let you slow down.
It is an icy field.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's an icy field. Oh, that one's gonna mess me up. It looks like it's unbalanced, so it wobbles, even though it doesn't. It just gives you the effect that it does.
Eh, to some degree.
Wow. I like this better. It allows the balls to change around. See more of the different ones. Oh. All right, well, it's actually 10 o'clock. We've been having a lot of fun with this. But I think I'm going to go ahead and shut down and take it easy for the night. No, you're fine, Lurch, man. Lurkers are always welcome. Lurkers are always welcome. You know, you're always welcome in the stream to hang out. You can, you know, what you do with your time is what you do with your time. We're just glad that, you know, you come and chose to hang out with us. It's a level of motion that I don't think I have capability for right now. But so this is Momentum. It is available on Steam right now, obviously, for pre-order. And then you'll be able to pick it up, and it comes out on Friday the 12th. There's the wheel going around. That's cool. So if it's something you're interested in, go give it a little bit of look. Go give it a little bit of loving, and we will go from there. He did give me a code for it. So it looks like we have a couple of people in the stream. If you guys are interested in it, I'll throw it up real quick. And we will do a giveaway. So we will do that. So, see, 6 minutes, that's fine. So as always, just to do that, go ahead and throw enter. It will cost you one coin, and you must be a follower in order to get it. Because, you know, I'm a jerk like that. So, and if you guys, if you're not don't think there would be something that you would be interested in, that's fine too. We'll just hold it. I'll give the key away at a later date. But I said that we're going to give it away, so we got a couple of people in here. We'll see what happens. We'll go play another level here real quick, just so that we're doing something instead of just sitting here waiting for time to expire. Not this one again. No, I'm done with this one. This one makes my finger hurt. It's not as bad as the dubstep. What was it?
Dub Wars.
I played that one. There's one of their levels that physically gave me a headache. Like, physically caused me pain.
I can see that.
Yeah. It's an amazing game. I loved it. All right, so nobody entered. I'll just put that code back. We'll save it. We'll give it away at a later date. But I want to definitely thank you for coming by, Kelly, and you know, letting me look at your game and do like that. I will make sure, as soon as we get shut down here, I'll start porting it over to YouTube, and then I'll shoot you the information for that. So, all right, with that, guys, we're going to go ahead and shut down the stream, and we will holler at y'all. Actually, I'll probably be on tomorrow night. Hepcat is out of town this week, so we may do some extra streams this week. So with that, y'all have a good night, and we will holler at y'all later.